Hachette Audio presents Never Give Up, Relentless Determination to Overcome Life's Challenges. Written by Joyce Meyer. Read by Sandra McCollom.
Introduction. More than anything else, I want you to know you can have a deep, intimate, personal relationship with God through Jesus Christ and the very best life has to offer. God is no respecter of persons. See Acts chapter 10, verse 34, and His promises apply equally to everyone. Yes, you can have the very best God offers, but you will have to be determined to never give up until you have succeeded in every area of life. I believe God has a great purpose for you, and I urge you to not settle for anything less. He wants to bless you and give you a life that will not only thrill you, fulfill you, and bring you deep joy and sweet satisfaction, but also challenge you, stretch you, and frustrate you at times. You may even have moments when you are tempted to give up. Think of this audiobook as a manual to use as you pursue the best in every area of your life. It will give you the inspiration you need to keep putting one foot in front of the other when you grow weary on your journey and remind you over and over again in a variety of ways, you can do it if you never give up. It will give you strength to soar above life's tests and trials like a majestic eagle, increase your determination, and teach you how to turn adversities into opportunities. It will empower you to persevere and build your confidence in God's ability to see you through to the achievement of the goals He has given you. It will strengthen your faith in His desire to fulfill the dreams He has put in your heart. One of the primary reasons people give up is that they try things, don't succeed, and feel like a failure. The truth is that we are never a failure unless we give up. When we don't succeed at something, many times we do not have the courage to try again, and we settle for less than we could achieve or enjoy if we would simply keep trying. The fact is, we all have times when things just don't work out the way we hope they will, even though we do our best. We may fail at one thing or even a few things, but that certainly does not make us a failure in life. I believe these temporary setbacks are part of life, and we must experience them in order for us to ever be truly successful. Failing at some things on our way to success humbles us and teaches us lessons we need to learn. For people who never give up, failure is simply the fuel for greater determination and success in the future. Some of the most successful people in history failed and instead of being discouraged, refused to give up. For example, consider the following. Henry Ford, who invented the automobile, went broke 5 times before he succeeded in business. The great dancer and movie star Fred Astaire took a screen test at MGM Studios in 1933. A studio memo reported he was slightly bald, could not act, and could dance a little. The family of Louisa May Alcott, the great author who wrote the popular book Little Women, thought she should abandon the idea of being a writer and become a seamstress instead. A newspaper fired Walt Disney for lack of ideas, and he went bankrupt several times before building Disneyland. Enrico Caruso's parents believed a voice teacher who said he had no future in music. He simply could not sing at all. He did not believe the teacher and became one of the most famous opera singers in the world. Theodore Roosevelt suffered the deaths of both his mother and his wife on the same day in 1884 before he became a war hero and a very effective president of the United States. John Wesley, the founder of Methodism, was often asked to not return to churches after preaching in them once. When he preached on the streets, townspeople kicked him out. When he preached in a meadow, people turned a bull loose on him. But later, because he refused to give up, he preached in a pasture and 10,000 people came to hear him. The story of Abraham Lincoln also amazes me. In the face of many defeats, he had reason to believe there was no way he could succeed in life or be president of the United States. At 22 years old, he failed in business. 1 year later, he ran for the legislature and lost. When he was 24, he experienced a second business failure. At 26, the woman he loved passed away, and he suffered a nervous breakdown the next year. When he was 29, he lost another political race, and at 34, he made an unsuccessful run for Congress. At 37, he did get elected to Congress, only to be defeated again 2 years later. At 46, he lost his bid for the Senate, and the next year, he failed in his attempt to become vice president. When he was 49, he was defeated for the Senate again. He had four sons, but only one lived to adulthood. But at 51 years of age, Abraham Lincoln was elected President of the United States and successfully led the country through one of its most difficult periods. Many people would have said, "No way," but not Lincoln. He never gave up. I believe you are destined to do great things. God created you for a purpose. He has opportunities He wants to give you and assignments with which He wants to entrust you. I'm sure you have realized by this point in your life that you will face opposition as you follow God. People who are called to greatness meet great challenges. He never promised us it would be easy. In fact, He guarantees us adversities in His Word. He also promises to be with us through difficulties, to fight on our behalf, to strengthen us to overcome any obstacle we confront, and to give us the ability to overcome them under one condition, that we never give up. No matter what comes your way, refuse to quit. Before you get started, I want to remind you of a biblical truth that I want you to remember after you listen to this audiobook. God, who got you started in this spiritual adventure, shares with us the life of His Son and our Master, Jesus. He will never give up on you. Never forget that. 1 Corinthians chapter 1, verse 9, The Message. Chapter 1, Never Say No Way. Without the way, there is no going. Without the truth, there is no knowing. Without the life, there is no living. Thomas A. Kempis. Have you ever faced a situation and said, "There is no way this can ever be"? Maybe some of these thoughts weigh on your mind. There is no way I can handle the pressure at work. There is no way I can pay my bills at the end of the month. There is no way to save my marriage. There is no way my children will ever grow up to be responsible adults. There is no way I can keep my house clean and straight. There is no way for me to open my own business. There is no way I can go back to college at my age. There is no way I can lose the weight I need to lose. I want you to know there is always a way. It may not be easy. It may not be convenient. It may not come quickly. You may have to go over, under, around, or through. But if you will simply keep on keeping on and refuse to give up, you will find a way. I want you to promise yourself that you will never again say, "There is no way." The truth is, even when there seems to be no way, with God there is always a way. If you are a born-again Christian, the Spirit of God lives inside of you. All the creativity in the world resides in Him. And because He lives in you, you have access to all that creativity. The Holy Spirit can give you ideas that never occurred to you and show you ways to do things you never thought you could do. Instead of dwelling on our difficulties, we need to focus more on the fact that God is for us and His power is at work in us. Often we give up too easily, saying, "This is too hard," or "This is taking too long." We must stop looking at situations in our lives and thinking, "I really cannot handle this. It's too much for me. I've already tried too many times. I have to accept there is just no way it will ever happen." Instead, we need to say, I don't care whether there seems to be a way or not. Jesus is the way. His Spirit lives in me, and I will find a way. God promised He would make a way in the wilderness and rivers in the desert. See Isaiah chapter 43, verse 19.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.